In this video, we'll cover one of our most commonly asked questions, ActiveCampaign deliverability, how to keep your ActiveCampaign emails out of the spam folder. I'm Jason, growth specialist at Wildmail, where we help make ActiveCampaign even better for Europe-based businesses. Let's check it out. So first, before I dive into these 15 tips that we have on improving your ActiveCampaign deliverability, I'm going to go over an overview and some examples from ActiveCampaign themselves, their own support team. They've looked into some of our specific accounts that we'll share anonymously, of course, and they've given their feedback as to why they may have been experiencing specific deliverability issues and then how to go about solving that. So this gives a nice overview of what you should be focusing on, and then I'll give you 15 tips to address directly their points and the specific areas that you should be focused on. So what they said was authentication and list hygiene should be a common priority here across all your accounts. You should be focused on authentication, which we'll go over that in a second, and your list hygiene, segmentation, who you're sending to, etc. So let's take a look at these example accounts. First, they found that this account, number one, had a high spam complaint and high unsubscribe rates. They had no authentication on the account. The last time they sent something was months ago in this case, and the server was rated as good. So just to break this down, we've got high spam complaint and high unsubscribe rate, which means that the content they were sending was probably not relevant. We'll show you how to address that. They did not have any of their DKIM or SPF authentication, and they didn't have a consistent pattern of sending out content, sending out emails to their list. So a decrease in emails arriving in the inbox can also be paired with that inconsistent sending. And the server was rated good, at least. So for the second example, again, no authentication. Their server was rated as great. The metrics were generally good, but a decline in performance correlated with an increased sending volume towards a less engaged target. Again, this has to do with list hygiene. Okay, they ramped up their sending to a target segment or their entire audience. Maybe they weren't segmenting at all, and they just blasted out emails, increased their volume after not sending for a while, and they didn't get good engagement with those people receiving their emails. And so the deliverability was impacted from that point on. And then account number three, no authentication. The server was good. They had a ton of inactive users. Again, list hygiene. They're not cleaning their list of inactive contacts. And then finally, we've got a very high abuse rate on a series of campaigns to 20K users that were no longer active on the platform. They had no authentication. They were impacted by the changes with Apple, but you can see common themes here around not having authentication, not cleaning inactive contacts, not segmenting to send relevant content. Remember, relevancy is the name of the game here. You want to send the right message to the right contact at the right time. So let's get into the tips so we can see how we can actually address authentication and list hygiene, among a few other things. Now, I just mentioned authentication multiple times, and that paired with list hygiene, those are the two main factors for deliverability. I'm going to drop the link to this here for SPF, DKIM, and DMARC authentication in the description below. This is basically how an inbox server is going to understand that the email that it's receiving is legitimate, that it's your business sending that email. And so you definitely want to set this up before moving on to the list hygiene strategies that I'll talk about in the 15 tips that are coming up. So check this link in the description below. So first and foremost, you want to be able to remove inactive contacts, and this will address the list hygiene issue. Now, we have an automation running. We'll have a video on that. You can check out our channel and check out the description below for that video on how we automatically remove and clean our lists. We want to make sure that we're only sending out content to those people that still want to hear from us and that are engaged. Tip number two, focus on sharing helpful, engaging content. We're going to hit this point a few different times on this list, but in order to share helpful, engaging content, you have to understand your audience. You can do that through quizzes at the top of the funnel. And you also want to segment so that what you're sharing is of interest to that audience segment. You don't want to send the same content to everyone on your list, just blasting it out. You want to be able to segment your users. So tip number three builds off number two, review your signup process and then try to think like a subscriber. If I signed up to get information about, let's say, pants from an e-com store And then they're blasting me with offers for glasses or jewelry. You know, that's not what they signed up for originally. That's not the content they originally opted in for. And so relevancy is decreased. You're going to have issues with deliverability there. People won't be engaging with your content. So to send, tip number four, to send more targeted personalized emails, you can trigger by contact behavior instead of just blasting out to all contacts. Again, segmentation for relevancy, send the right message to the right people at the right time. And you can check out this video in order to do that. Inside ActiveCampaign, you can go, and when you send out a campaign here, for example, when I create a draft for a newsletter, just to create a campaign, and we'll say test. And you can see here, I can select a list. Let's say main list English. But then I can go and select a segment here that I've created, or I can create an entirely new segment and do so by adding different conditions so that only a specific interested group of that overall list is going to receive this email, which is going to increase engagement, increase open rates, because we're increasing relevancy. So that's essentially telling the server, okay, this is a list that is engaged. They want to receive this content, and it has contacts that are reacting positively and engaging positively with your email campaigns. And you can do the same in your automations as well. Now, moving on, if we go to number five, your sending frequency. Typically, we've seen people sending 2 times a week minimum, but what you don't want to do is have irregular sending habits, so inconsistent sending habits. Like we mentioned up here, ActiveCampaign tag one account, because the last time they sent something was months ago, and then all of a sudden they blasted out to their list. Same here, the metrics were generally good, but they had decline in performances, which correlated with an increase in volume towards the less engaged targets. They started ramping up the volume, started ramping up the amount of emails they were sending and the frequency as well. And they were doing so towards a less engaged target. And so they saw a decline in performance from that. Now, number six here, pay attention to the ActiveCampaign spam filter and test before sending. Let me show you what that looks like. When I go ahead here and I go to create an email, we'll just use this. Pick a random one. You can see here when I go to settings and spam check passed. Now, if I put something like that in the subject. Now, what I've done is I've entered free money for you and your business. Reply ASAP to get it now before it's too late. It's free forever right now. In the subject line as well, I've got buy now, free, respond ASAP, free money for you is waiting. You can see here, subject line starts with buy or buying, and it has failed the spam check. So you always want to be checking this beforehand. It will give you different errors depending on what you've included, if it shouldn't be included, if they feel it's going to trigger the spam filter. And another tool, a little bonus for you that I like to use, is called Mailmeteor. Now, this tool is quite strict, and so it will probably give you an overall score of poor, even if you have an okay score here in ActiveCampaign and it says passed, because this is being quite harsh on your writing. You'll see it grades urgency, shady, overpromising, unnatural, and it'll give you, you know, the read time, etc. But this is just another way on top of using ActiveCampaign spam check. You can pop your email copy in here and see if it's triggering this spam checker. And as you can see, it says it helps you validate your emails before sending them. It detects specific words that can trigger spam filters. So feel free to use this. I'll link it in the description below. Next up, don't send graphics or images. It can create a poor experience for the user. And also, whenever someone sends, especially to a new list or a new contact, whenever someone sends a heavier email, so obviously if it's containing graphics, images, videos, it's going to be heavier. Those typically contain viruses or malicious content. And so you can trigger the spam filter that way. If you haven't warmed up your account, you don't want to be sending a bunch of graphics and images. And it can also load poorly if someone has their images turned off so that their email inbox isn't loading the images. It can look poor when they see in their inbox your email. It can look like an error, or, you know, it loads poorly. So it provides a bad experience for your contacts. Don't use a free email as your from address. Use an email that's related to your business, not something general like a Gmail account or something sketchy that they won't recognize. Number nine, don't send too many links. And you want to be mindful of the domain reputation of the link that you are sending, especially when you're just starting out with your account. 10, similar to number 9, don't use the link shortening services. This can trigger the spam filter because often malicious links that are sent in bad emails are done so using these shorteners. Number 11, send using a consistent from name and address. That helps train the contacts to trust your name that they see the email was sent from and trust the email that it's sent from as well. Number 12, check that your automations are sending correctly. We had a case one time where we had switched up some tags and the emails that we were trying to send in a drip sequence were all sending rapidly at once. It creates a bad experience and people can mark your emails as spam, of course, or block your account, which can affect your deliverability from there. 13, don't use the same email subject line. You can test for open rates using different email subject lines and increased open rates, increased engagement. That's going to help with your deliverability. 14, make it very easy to unsubscribe, especially if you're reaching back out to try to re-engage a segment of your list that you haven't engaged in a while. You can add another unsubscribe link at the top to make it super clear, super easy so that they don't mark it as spam. They just simply unsubscribe. So you want to give them that option in every email as well. It's required. And then number 15, get better engagement with the community to hack the algorithm for the spam filter. So one of the ways that you want to do this is setting up double opt-in. And yes, it might seem like a bit of additional friction added in. They have to go and, you know, they opt in once on the pop-up form, then they have to click the link in the first email. But first of all, you're training them to engage with your content, to click links in your content, and to basically tell the inbox server, hey, I want to receive this. This email is okay from this person, which is great. So some people do it, they have double opt-in, they have instructions to drag the email to the inbox to make sure that it's whitelisted. They simply have them reply hello or reply with some open-ended response signaling that yes, this email is trusted and you want to continue receiving emails from this account. So that is another way. Now, I have one last tip for you. Now, many people ask about splitting up their cold outreach and their typical evergreen marketing automation emails. Should they use the same server, the same domain to do cold outreach as they use for the rest of their marketing emails? The answer is no, you should split it up. You should actually buy multiple domains so you can use those for cold outreach, and you can use a tool like Instantly to have AI-powered email warm-up. So I'll just show you quickly. This is Instantly here. You can see improve email delivery with unlimited warm-up. AI optimizations for deliverability and response. They've taught their trained their artificial intelligence system to automatically optimize email sending patterns for maximum opens. You can actually set this up with multiple domains, multiple emails, and it will cycle through and warm up these different accounts. You know, it doesn't matter if someone's using ActiveCampaign through Wildmail, HubSpot, whatever email marketing service you're using, if someone tells you they can get you 100% deliverability, 100% of your emails will arrive in the inbox, that's not true. It's impossible. But there are certain steps you can take that we described before in the tips and with platforms like Instantly that can help you get your emails to arrive in the inbox of your contacts. Now, if you have any questions about how this applies to you specifically, feel free to drop them in the comments below. We'd be happy to help out. Now, I mentioned earlier I'd explain more about Wildmail, and at Wildmail, we are one of the top resellers of ActiveCampaign in the world, and at its core, Wildmail is just ActiveCampaign, so nothing changes with your pricing, your API integrations, your email sequences, your campaigns, your login, your password. It all stays the same because it is ActiveCampaign at its core. We inherit your next billing cycle, so you don't get charged anything additional by us, but your next billing cycle will be through us, and then that allows us to stack additional benefits for free on top, especially for Europe-based businesses. So first, we've got premium localized support. We are based in Europe, and we're leveraging years of experience as an ActiveCampaign agency in the past to help you get the most out of this tool today. You'll get custom onboarding with our support team, plus anyone on a plus plan or above will get a package of free consulting calls with us. If you're already working with a third-party agency or in-house, no worries, we'll do it with them. Now, we also have a library of free training you can use. And finally, we have Wild Metrics. Wildmetrics is our no-code API-based tracking app for the customer journey in ActiveCampaign. This allows you to track revenue by tags, revenue by automations, revenue by email campaigns. You can build out beautiful dashboards to make sense of the data and then optimize your campaigns to hit your next revenue goal. And you'll get a free account for that as well. So if you've never used ActiveCampaign before or Wildmail, you'll see a link below for a 14-day free trial through us. If you are using ActiveCampaign, no worries. You can move. There's no migration process. It's just moving the billing to us. It's a 5 to 10 minute process, super fast, and we can help you with that process. There's another link for moving your account below to get those additional benefits for free. And if you have any questions at all about Wildmail, just drop them below in the comments or shoot us an email and we'd be happy to answer those for you. If you got value from this video, make sure to subscribe for more ActiveCampaign tutorials and hit the like button so we can reach more people just like you with this content. That's it from me. I'll see you next tutorial. Cheers.